Hello, my sisters and brothers of the stars. Welcome to the Nuit Report of, or for, May 24th, 2019. I'm April Shaley, and today we have a square aspect, or a charged conversation, like an argument almost, you could say, between Chiron, the wounded healer in Aries, and Mars, the god of war, the warrior aspect, warrior energy in Cancer. Now, Mars is considered to be in his fall in Cancer, so he's not like super happy in the sign of the Great Mother necessarily. According to the ancient astrologers, he is, you know, Cancer's all about home and family and your private life, even your ancestry. It's like from the roots, where you come from, and you know, the source of life. And Mars is about individuality and you know, the yang part of who we are, you know, separation. And this is me as an individual. These are my boundaries that I'm going to have and protect and all this. Now, what he does do well in Cancer is he protects the home. But he sort of gets, you know, sort of tethered to being home. So he's not, you know, Mars wants to get out there and have adventure and, like, you know, whatever. He wants to be able to be action oriented and not all about, you know, he doesn't want to be a mama's boy staying at home, right? That's not what he's looking for. But in Cancer, that's his, you know, that's what he does. And that's fine. In an aspect with Chiron, it's like a square is like a conversation that's charged. It's a spirited conversation, otherwise known as an argument. Right? And Chiron is the wounded healer. So this is Mars not feeling that groovy, like in this position here, because he's sort of emasculated and, you know, not feeling like he's got the biggest balls in the world, really, to put it bluntly and vulgarly. And, you know, hopefully you laugh because, you know, and this is the energy that we have going on right now. So, you know, some of you out there who are men or who are masculine facing in your expression, you know, the yang, the animus, you know, this part, this wounded, the wounded aspects of that energy are sort of playing themselves out right now. So, you know, this can be a time when people feel like a little bit maybe weak, or, you know, just aren't feeling as good and as confident as they might want to feel going forward into the world, taking action. This can be a time when we might feel a little bit of doubt. So if that kind of thing's coming up, just know this is why you listen to the Nuit Report, right? So you're like, oh, I heard about this. This is going to pass. So it's okay to feel this for a little while. It's okay to feel a little bit not confident and to maybe retreat a bit and stay at home and tend to myself and, you know, because Chiron, like, brings out where we're wounded, right? The wounded healer. He's also, of course, going to heal where we're wounded. That's the idea. The wound is where the light gets in, right? So Chiron is, that's, you know, it's not, he's not just there to show us, ha, wounded, weak, oh well. Like, that's not all there is to it. Although that can be it too, is like, we have to surrender to the fact that we're just human. And it's okay to just be human. It's okay to not be confident all the time. It's really brave, in fact, to admit that and sit with that for a while and let that teach you something. Chiron is also the teacher. He is wisdom. And through the wounds that we have, you know, that's sort of how, through our suffering and then our compassion for other people, hopefully, and, you know, the things that, the alchemy that suffering can cause, we gain more wisdom and more clarity about life. And so that's the gift inherent in this square, is that. So, you know, it will bring out, like, where we feel maybe, like, impotent, you know, like, I want to do more about this. Like, maybe a family member, like, a really good way, you know, example of how this could play out. Doesn't mean this is going to happen for you, but it just as an example, you know, a family member is having a mental health problem or a health problem in general, like whatever. They're all the same anyway, physical, mental health, it's very much intertwined. So part of the same thing. And we can't do anything about it. We want to take action. We want to go, you know, aggressively at it. We want to, you know, say the right thing, and we maybe feel kind of, you know, ineffective or unable to be the champion that we wish we could be. And it's going to take a more receptive and quiet and loving sort of approach to deal with. It's not something we can just go at and fix. It's not going to be a problem that's going to get solved today, which is really hard for the masculine part of our psyches, everybody's, you know, because we want to fix stuff. Especially those of us who are, like I say, male or masculine in orientation, like there is that impulse to try to fix things, you know, because that's part of what you want to do, and maybe you can't right now. And so there's acceptance to this aspect. It's not sexy. You know, it's not that hot. It's not going to feel hot right now, this particular thing. Okay, so it's more just to be aware, oh, okay, that may be why I'm feeling the way I'm feeling right now, you know, and it's going to pass as Mars continues to move forward through Cancer and the Zodiac throughout the rest of the month into June, you know, this is going to move on. Now, another thing that's happening is Mercury. Mercury is how we think, speak, communicate, how we, you know, the mental plane, how, you know, our mind and travel, also business, that's making a square to Neptune in a couple days. And that's really good for creative work and to look at things in like a softer lens. I think of like the Hanged Man in the tarot, which nobody really likes picking that card that much. If you're familiar with the tarot, you work with the cards, you know, that's when we're just like, ah, because it's like, it's sacrifice and it's, you know, maybe being at a standstill. But in the Norse mythology, you know, when Odin was hung up, you know, from the tree, from the world tree, you know, he lost an eye and stuff. That's a sacrifice. But we don't need to talk about that part. We'll just talk about the part where he created the runes, this magical system. And each rune is a spell. And it's, you know, obviously a really valuable thing that happened from this event. So, you know, the Hanged Man is a way of looking at the world from a different perspective, being upside down. Neptune, Mercury is also like tells us that there's another way of looking at the world, that there's more possibility to looking at the world. There's a more poetic way to look at things. There's a more creative way. And so if we are, you know, we're moving into this week, we start to feel like things get a little foggy or confused, that's your signal. Again, you're listening to the NUIT report, so you're prepared. You know what this is. That's your signal. If things start to get sort of weird, you know, and it's like, it's a non-rational aspect. So you can't, again, it's this whole week's kind of like this, where you can't come at things with clear direction, logic, and go-get-itiveness. Like you're gonna have to sort of be more like a dancer and sort of listen to the music as it's happening and move in the ways that you feel from your inner core is the right thing to do. It's sort of like a martial arts kind of thing. Like Mars in a square with Chiron, that's kind of like martial arts. You know, think of it that way. This practice of martial artistry, Mars, martial, right? That's what that's from. And then the artistry, you know, is also this Mercury, Neptune square. This is also a charged conversation, again, between the way, you know, the mind, and then the Neptune is the oneness of the universe, which is like, how do you articulate that? How do you put that into words? Well, that's kind of the trick with Mercury in the square with Neptune. How do you put that into words? What kinds of ways do we have to communicate things that are bigger than words? And that does come through dance and poetry, music, sculpture, all different kinds of creativity where we use symbols and we use movement and we use, you know, verbal in a way that's not prosaic, that's not just about, you know, gathering and disseminating information, but has to do with, you know, the music of the words, right? Just the wanting to listen to them and understand the world in a different and more profound way. And our common humanness, or, you know, our common humanity, that this week, you know, compassion and our common humanity. And, you know, this is a week where we may need to check in with the ways that, you know, because of what's going on the world stage and maybe some of the ways that those things are manifesting in our personal lives, there's a lot of polarization going on right now. How are we maybe dehumanizing other people? You know, we might have a very, you know, important and what's the word I'm looking for? Valid complaint that we have been dehumanized in some way. And we might feel like victims, and that can really come out this week, that we feel, you know, our victimhood and our, you know, that wounding. And this is a week to sort of shift that tendency to feel like we're a victim into something where we feel like we're victorious, and not necessarily by, you know, subjugating somebody else or dehumanizing somebody else, because that is our tendency sometimes. Maybe we have to go through that, whatever, but it's part of the process. But, you know, the victor in that, we take the reins on our own lives and start directing ourselves toward what it is, you know, our vision for what we want and our vision for how we want to feel. And that's kind of the key thing right now. How do you want to feel? So just playing the same loop of how you act, how you feel right now. You know, I mean, it's good to get present with that, get centered with that, get honest about that, all that stuff. But like, how do you want to feel? Instead of just reacting to everything that's going on around you and feeling like a victim, because victims are the most violent people, you know, frankly. Unhappy people are the ones who are violent. And violence can come in a lot of forms. It doesn't have to be physical violence, you know, emotional violence, mental violence, and toward ourselves as well. You know, just the way we're thinking about ourselves and what we're allowing ourselves to enjoy. And, you know, what we're withholding from ourselves. I mean, God, if you really pay attention to, you know, your thought process, sometimes when we go unconscious, we can really say, wow, you know, I'm kind of doing a lot of this to myself. We have a lot more control than we think we do. But this is a week where we might not, you know, be feeling that so much. So, you know, give yourself some space for that. So we're going to pull our card for the week. And I'm going to shuffle those cards right now. Again, you know, I talk about this every week. We do have this Pluto-Saturn conjunction getting more and more, you know, more and more closer. You know? And it's like, it is. Like, we're in this garbage compactor. That's like the walls are closing in a little bit more. There's that anxiety backdrop. And so that makes it crucial that we set intention and we use our will and choice making capacity to decide, you know, what we're gonna contribute to this collective shift that's happening. We're gonna contribute more negativity and polarization and, you know, disharmony and unhumanity, if that's a word, that's the word we're going to use right now. Are we going to contribute something toward what we want to see? You know, that's up to you. All right, so card for today, or this week, is, pulling from the Smith Rider Waite deck, the Page of Wands. And I like this guy. He's got a red feather in his hat. Like, that's kind of sassy, right? He's looking at this wand, sort of holding it up, regarding it like, huh, what am I going to do with this thing? Hey, what am I going to do with this wand? He's wearing red and yellow, so it's very fiery. It's a little arid, the background, so it's not like super, you know, fertile per se. So it's more like heat, it's like heat and fire and passion and inspiration. So this is like, you know, a messenger that there, you know, that if you have an inspiration, if something is coming to you right now, You know, it can, again, as we sort of soften a little bit, soften the way that we're thinking and not think so hard-edged and so intensely about what we think we know, but sort of come at things with more curiosity, like this guy, what might come up? What inspirations might come up that we ourselves may be surprised at what emerges? And then the Page of Wands is a messenger. You know, the inspiration itself is a messenger of the next direction to take. What that inspiration is it tells us like where our path is. People always say, what's my path? What's my life path? Well, pay attention to those inspirations. Pay attention to those desires that come up, because those are the things that tell you what that is. All right? So make sure you subscribe to these videos if you haven't already. Hit the little bell so you get a notification. And come over to our Patreon page, patreon.com/aprilsastrology, because we have lots of things going on over there. And I appreciate your support. And this report was brought to you by my patrons on Patreon. All right. Many thanks to them. Take care and many blessings.